It is your duty to take care of your car if you own one. To ensure that your car runs well for a long time, you must regularly check the fluids such as the oil, gas, and coolant. There are numerous sensors and features in modern cars that help them run smoothly. Having a basic understanding of your car can help you deal with mechanical issues. In this video, I will try to explain why your car shuts off while you're driving. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Faulty fuel pump or fuel system. The right amount of fuel is delivered to the engine by a fuel pump. The motor will shut off if the fuel pump does not supply the engine with the proper fuel, leaving you stranded. Unfortunately, there is no bypass for a malfunctioning fuel pump. You must either fix it or purchase a new one. Another possibility is that the fuel pump is unable to pump fuel through the fuel filter because it became clogged. The sole purpose of a fuel filter is to clean the fuel before it enters the engine. The engine will shut off if the fuel filter becomes clogged because there won't be enough fuel getting into the system. Fortunately, changing a fuel filter is simple for you. The majority of fuel pumps are mounted within the fuel tank. When the car shuts off, a little mechanic's trick is to give the fuel tank a kick with your foot or something comparable. If the car starts at that point, your fuel pump most likely has a problem. The fuel tanks are made of plastic, so be careful not to hit them with anything sharp. Doing so could result in a hole being made, which is the last thing you want. When your car abruptly restarts after turning off while you're driving, a bad fuel pump is frequently to blame. Faulty crankshaft position sensor. A malfunctioning crankshaft position sensor is the most frequent cause of a vehicle cutting out while in motion. On the majority of car models, the crankshaft sensor is required for the engine to function. On some car models, you also have a camshaft position sensor, which the vehicle will use in the event that the camshaft sensor is broken. However, a malfunctioning crankshaft position sensor may not result in a complete stop of the vehicle. In contrast, if your vehicle only has a crankshaft position sensor and no camshaft sensor and you receive a trouble code, you must replace the sensor. Empty fuel tank. The majority of car owners are likely aware of the importance of periodically checking your fuel level while driving. It's great if you have enough fuel for your trip, but if your fuel gauge or fuel level sender is broken and does not accurately reflect the amount of fuel in your car, you could be in serious trouble. Fill your car with 1 gallon of fuel and see if it starts to check if your fuel gauge or fuel level sensor is malfunctioning. Alternator problems. Your car's alternator controls the flow of electricity. The alternator may have failed if your car stops running all of a sudden. Vital auto parts won't receive power from a malfunctioning alternator, and you'll notice the dash lights going out or the engine suddenly losing power. You may occasionally see a red battery light on your dashboard if your alternator is failing. The alternator is not the issue, though, if your car still has electrical power and the starter motor functions after it shut off while you were driving. Faulty ignition switch. Your car may occasionally shut off while you're driving as a result of a broken ignition switch. When you turn the key to start the car, the ignition switch, which is situated behind the ignition lock, is activated. Tiny metal plates within this switch are susceptible to corrosion and rust buildup. If this takes place and one of these plates separates, the entire ignition will be turned off. Additionally, the entire engine will abruptly shut off as a result of this. Fortunately, if so, it is simple to check. Check to see if there are any lights or ignition lights on your dashboard when the car shuts off. There is a good chance that the ignition switch is broken if the dashboard instrument is dead. Malfunctioning sensors. Numerous sensors are used by modern vehicles to optimize the air-fuel ratio for reduced fuel consumption. Your car's engine could completely shut off if one sensor malfunctions and is turned off. Fortunately, most of these sensors can't completely turn off the engine. The air-fuel mixture could be so severely messed up by sensors like the MAF sensor, coolant temperature sensor, and oxygen sensor that the engine would stall. How to fix a car that shuts off while driving. First of all, check trouble codes. Older car models required you to use a multimeter or your common sense to diagnose the vehicle's issue. Fortunately, newer vehicles come equipped with diagnostic software that can identify when an engine sensor is malfunctioning and record a fault code. You no longer need to waste time measuring every sensor in your car's engine, which greatly simplifies diagnosis. Additionally, you don't have to guess and swap out the incorrect parts. Therefore, checking these trouble codes in the engine control module to see if there is any stored issue is the best way to figure out why your car shuts off while you are driving. But you need an OBD2 scanner to read the fault codes. You have two options: either you purchase one on your own, or you visit a repair shop, where they will read the codes for you. Using the information from the diagnostic scanner, continue troubleshooting. For instance, if the crankshaft position sensor has a trouble code, you should check the wiring to the sensor and probably replace it. Check alternator voltage. The next thing you should do is check the alternator voltage while the engine is running if you don't have an OBD2 scanner or are unable to locate any stored error codes. Basically, all you have to do is turn on the engine and use a multimeter to check the battery voltage. If the reading is less than 12.5 volts, your alternator might be malfunctioning. Fill the fuel tank. Even though it might seem obvious that you need to fill up the fuel tank, you might not even be aware that you need fuel. Because the fuel pump will start sucking air instead of fuel. Low fuel can cause the engine to stall when cornering at higher speeds. Additionally, there is a chance that your tank's fuel gauge sensor is malfunctioning, causing your fuel level to be low even though your fuel gauge indicates it is full. Therefore, you should definitely check this by opening the fuel cap and adding a little fuel. Check fuel pressure. You should check the fuel pressure in your car because low fuel pressure is another issue that could cause it to shut off while you're driving. Connecting a manual pressure gauge to the fuel rail or line is the ideal way to check the fuel pressure. If the vehicle has a pressure sensor, you can also use a diagnostic scanner to measure the pressure from it. But there is always a chance that the sensor will not work properly. Examine the fuel filter, fuel pump, and fuel pressure regulator if you notice that the fuel pressure is low. If it is, check the fuel pressure specifications for your car. Check the tachometer. In most car models, the crankshaft position sensor provides the data to the RPM meter or so-called tachometer on your dashboard. When your car shuts off while you are driving or does not move when the engine is started, it may indicate that there is a problem with the crankshaft position sensor or camshaft position sensor. Check your dashboard. When your car shuts off, the next thing you should check is the dashboard lights. A problem with the ignition switch may be present if you notice that the dashboard lights turn off when the car engine shuts off. However, as we previously mentioned, it can also be brought on by low battery voltage as a result of a faulty alternator. But if that's the case, you should definitely check both of these. Talk to a professional. If you've tried the suggestions above and your car still shuts off while you're driving, it might be a good idea to get professional assistance. Although it might be expensive, it might be a good idea to seek assistance from someone who has dealt with this problem numerous times before. Additionally, hiring a mechanic may not necessarily cost more if he can quickly and accurately identify the issue without replacing the wrong components. Hope this information was helpful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.